Good afternoon, everyone.
So let me first take you to the business highlights of the quarter. This was a very difficult quarter where in North America there is a substantial price erosion and volume decline, and specifically on the key molecules, which has been giving us quite a good sales and profit. And on top of it, there have been no new launches. And as you know, last quarter itself, while taking the provisions in Venezuela, we said that we will not make any more dispatch unless and until we get some cash repatriation. So there was no further repatriation, and we also didn't make any sales in Venezuela. And last year in the same quarter, we had 177 crores of sales. So that accounts for almost one third of the total sales decline year on year. So the entire profit decline is primarily due to the lower sales, because R&D and SG&A is as per plan, and in the plan we factored in the remediation cost. On the quality management, our progress has been in line with expectation. There has been a substantial progress which has been made. And in proprietary products in North America, we have launched Sanibo. In terms of the corporate actions, the buyback that we initiated was completed, and we got the entire money allocated at an average price of ₹3,091 per share. Signed a definitive agreement to acquire the select portfolio from Teva. This is of course subject to FTC clearance, and the six OTC brands that we have taken in USA from Duce Pharma. So there have been a 14% decline in the top line, and in gross profit, the margin which was 61.1% previous year, of course after the warning letter, the gross profit margin came down in subsequent quarters. Like in Q3 and Q4, specifically Q4, it was just 56.6. In line with that, the gross profit is almost in line sequentially. But year on year, there has been a 500 basis point decline in gross profit. R&D, in absolute terms, we are not making any compromise in terms of R&D plan, so we are continuing. But as a percentage of sales, it has gone up quite a bit because of low sales. It is 14.8% now. So EBITDA, we ended up closer to 400 crores, and so it looks pretty low as a percentage of sales. But as I said, primarily the reason is low net sales in this quarter. And the decline has been there in all the three, in North America, Europe, as well as emerging markets. But emerging markets, if we exclude Venezuela, then rest of the emerging markets, it would have grown by 2%. In India, there has been a 10% growth. So in USA, in revenue, there is a 16% decline. From 1852, it has come down to 1552. There has been quite a bit of price erosion which has happened in our key molecules, as I said earlier. And the share also, because of the competition, has come down. And with an exception of esomeprazole, where we have increased the market share now, which has now come up to 15%. So as on the pipeline is concerned, we out of the 234 cumulative filings, we have 78 pending approvals. And 50 of them are Para 4 filings, and we believe we are first to file in 18 of them. So the focus on augmenting the pipeline continues, and we hope there will be more launches in the coming quarters. Specifically in the second half, we expect a good number of launches. In the emerging markets, as I said, if you really exclude Venezuela, then there has been a growth. So primary drop is there in rest of the world. But in the rest of the world also, if you would have excluded Venezuela, the business would have grown by 19% year on year. Russia in constant currency, there has been a growth of 23%. But last year in the same quarter, 1 ruble was 1 rupee 20 paisa. And this time it is roughly around 1 rupee. So there is a straightaway currency effect which comes in. So OTC as a total percentage of revenue stands at 40% there. In India, the momentum in mega brand is continued. Obviously, there is an impact of the NLEM which is there. And in terms of the MQT growth, Dr. Reddy's is standing at 11.6 versus the market growth of 8.8%. In PSAI, the sales is continuing to get impacted because of difficulty in dispatch, primarily on account of the ongoing quality improvement initiatives that we are doing there. So in terms of DMF filings, we have now cumulative 784 DMFs, out of which in USA, 218 are filed so far. So CapEx, in line with what we committed earlier, we are continuing to spend. And in the current quarter, on the Q1, we spent 324 crore. In R&D, also we are continuing. So in terms of the cash flow, in the first quarter, it has come down to 185 crores. And our net debt equity ratio is now back to net debt of 0.11. This is after the buyback that we have done. So effective first April, we have also started, we adopted the Ind AS in lieu of the IGAAP. And there is a difference in the profit before tax. Ind AS would have been higher by 28 crores. And the difference is basically because of the, you know, the gap treatment difference between IFRS and Ind AS. So the accounting in terms of the fair value charge itself, mark to market on mutual funds, there is a 11 crore gap. And the depreciation amortization on all the, you know, PPE and intangible assets, you know, there, 24 crore gaps are there, but it is offset by the, you know, we have the joint venture in China. So basically in IFRS, we take that as a equity accounted. That thing is not there in India, so 7.4 crore get offset. So that's why there is a 28 crore difference. But for all practical purpose, since we have been always explaining to you on IFRS, so we are going to continue explaining to the investors in terms of our IFRS numbers. So the key priorities for us is, of course, the top priority is on US FDA warning letter and closure of all the CGMP audit action items. And then the most important is in terms of our development and launch milestones for both complex and specialty pipeline. Now, this is what we have been investing significantly in our R&D, and this is what which will create value for Dr. Reddy's in the long term. But simultaneously, we are also focusing on operational excellence to achieve the cost leadership, and which will continue. And in emerging markets, we are definitely looking at increasing more penetration.